As a future educator, have you asked this to yourself? Well, today I will be discussing all about self-assessment under the subject course Assessment of Learning. So self-assessment is a powerful learning strategy. Students who can assess their own learning are more effective learners. They are more motivated and engaged, have a greater belief that they can succeed at anything in life, and are able to adapt their approach if learning is not working. Assessment-capable students show higher achievement. I believe that an assessment-capable student is very effective. If you can assess yourself, where are your weaknesses and where are your strengths, then you can know which path or which approach you can use to make it right or to make it more easier for your studies. So, what does self-assessment look like? Does it have a model? Does it have a phase? Or what does self-assessment look like? So self-assessment can take many forms, and it can be very quick and informal, or it might be more structured and important. So in essence though, self-assessment looks like students posing to examine what they do and don't know. So however, if you simply say, okay class, time to self-assess, you'll likely be met with a blank stare like, how do we self-assess, ma'am? Or how do we self-assess, sir? So, the more you're able to walk students through different strategies for self-assessment, the more they will understand the purpose, process, and value of thinking about their own learning. For the best results to reach the most students, aim to incorporate different types of self-assessment, just as you aim to incorporate different ways of teaching into your own lessons. As a future educator, we have different types on how to teach, okay? Or we have different ways on how to deliver our own lesson. So this is the same as for self-assessment, in which we have different types of approach in which we can see or notice or even look at a child or look at a particular student and how they can assess themselves if they are really learning. And also as an educator, we need to assess those students if they are really learning, you know. So because it would be really pointless and useless if we are discussing in front while your students are not learning at all. So how can we know if our students is learning or have they learned? So we need to use a self-assessment method or an approach. So why self-assessment works? What's the point of self-assessment if it doesn't work, right? So, why self-assessment works? One of the reasons self-assessment is so effective is because it helps students stay within their zone of proximal development. We have discussed already about zone of proximal development by Lev Vygotsky. So, I hope we have understood and fully aware of what is it. So in this zone, students are being challenged, which means they are learning, but they're not being pushed too hard into frustration. So in self-assessment, we can look at students at their own learning pace. So we are pushing them to do their best, but we are not pushing them to be frustrated and be stressed about a particular lesson. We are only pushing them to motivate and encourage them. So that is your work as a teacher, to push them, to motivate them, and to encourage them to study well and focus on their studies as much as possible. So the reason this is so helpful is because teachers can see anywhere from 15 to 150 plus students every day. It's hard for a teacher to know where every single student is at in his or her learning. When students are able to self-assess, they take control of their learning and realize when they need to ask more questions or spend more time working on a concept or a lesson. Self-assessment that is relayed back to the teacher, either formally or informally, helps the teacher get a better idea of where students are at with their own learning. So when a teacher has given a feedback by a student, or when a student approach a teacher and asks for a particular information about this topic, then we can know that they are encouraged and motivated. How to execute self-assessment? To truly make this part of your classroom, you'll need to explain to students what you are doing, why you're doing it, and you will need to hold them accountable for their own self-assessment. I mean, we can help them, but we cannot really control their self-assessment process or self-assessment making, because we have different types of learning. I may be learning too fast for you. You may be learning too slow for me. So we need to assess our own self on how fast, what strengths and what weaknesses do we possess in learning.